Excuse me.
Hey, hey, you got a visitor.
Shut up, you. Now, what you want?
My name's John Marston. You wanted to speak to me.
I did?
Apparently so.
Why?
I guess because we're both in the business of the law.
You that fella from the train company?
No, I'm from Fort Mercer.
Fort Mercer? You them, one of them Williamson boys.
Calm down.
Go on, shoot him, mister. Shoot him.
Come what? You getting cute with me, boy?
What's going on here?
I got me one of them Williamson boys.
I got me one of them idiots who give marshals a bad name.
Jonah, put your gun down. You must be the man from Blackwater.
Yes, sir. Listen, that dog ain't too bright, but he seems loyal.
Jonah, get out of here for a minute.
Yes, sir, Mr. Johnson, sir. And you. Oh, I done seen enough of your hide around here, friend.
I think there's some school children down the way you can go and frighten.
Oh, hardy fucking whore. Dickhead.
What are you doing here, Mr. Marston? Apart from frightening my deputies.
I'm here to capture or kill Bill Williamson.
Okay.
Can you help me?
He's outside my jurisdiction. He's in the next county. Of course, Bill Williamson and his boys have tended to keep themselves away from my town.
So you're happy to have him out there?
Well, I ain't happy, but I also ain't suicidal. My job is to keep this town safe, not clean up all of these three counties. It's hard enough around here.
You know, I hear you speak, and suddenly I'm reminded of how some of the people I respected most in my life had a problem with authority. What's wrong with you?
Well, I'm sure you and your fine friends have enjoyed spending your time running around pursuing noble causes. My cause is to keep this town from turning into a living hell for the folks who live here. Whole world has problems, mister, and I'm here doing what I can.
Why? What's happening?
Right now? I got the railway, the people who pay my salary, trying to get me to turn a blind eye to them burning down settlements up there. I got a bunch of cattle rustlers out near Box Canyon needs shutting down. Not forgetting the gang that keeps murdering homesteaders out in the backcountry. And I got a bunch of hoods over in the saloon, drunk, threatening to shoot up the whole town. That's all I got today. But it's early yet. Give me a couple more days. There'll be more.
All right. Tell you what. Let's go deal with them hoods in the saloon. Then we'll discuss Williamson.
Okay, boy. You're a persistent little cuss, ain't you?
Only when things matter.
Let's head over to the saloon.
So who are we looking for?
A bunch of two-bit hoodlums, led by this fella called Walt. Goddamn road agents who prey on the stages coming in and out of town. Drivers and armadillos spend more time with their hands in the air than on the reins these days.
And you're happy to let them drink in your saloon?
Happy? No. But the way I figure it, better they're carousing in there than out robbing decent folk.
That's an interesting approach to law enforcement.
Dumb rat bastard now. Let's follow him. See what kind of hole he crawls into.
Walton's the top screw. Let's get after him. on to it. Get after him.
As you say he is, why don't we just beef him now while we got the chance?
Because that ain't how the law works.
Is that right, Marshal?
And alive, he can still talk.
Doesn't sound like he's a man to be reasoned with.
He ain't. But a few days of my hospitality and he'll be telling me what I need to know. Walton's gang's been growing fast.
Outlawing's easy money for easy work.
Chola Springs, Gap Tooth Ridge, these boys get around. Walton's a start, but there's plenty more where he came from. The old Pleasant's house. Let's hold up a minute and find a spot for our horses. Looks like we got company, boys! Damn! Take cover! We'll work our way up this hill. Arston, I got you covered. Move up to that wagon. There's one behind the crate. Take him down. Now move up to that crate. I'll cover you. Take that cover behind the rock, boy. Take him alive. Walton, your killing days are over. It'll be trial and the rope for
Good
you.
Lord above.
Not a bad shot, Mr. Marston. Why don't you check in with me next time you're in town?
I don't want to be no policeman, Marshal.
Nor did I, my friend. I can promise you that. I'll see you soon, Mr. Marston.
Yeah. Oh, now.
Hello?
Is Armadillo 731? What is it with these things? Hello? It's a new line. Hello? Hello?
Sounds fun. What's happening?
I have no idea. If it's important, they'll send someone down like they did with you.
Suddenly, the world is full of theys.
Yeah. I remember when we first got here. We used to consider people from Dade County to be exotic. Now guys can get here from the Midwest, and they can do it in 6 days.
Things have changed.
They've gotten away from me. Hello? I don't understand it no more, boy. Honest goodness.
I'm not sure I do.
Marshall! 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 I've just been up in the canyon, spying like you said. I think I seen me a couple of them rustlers. I think it was the Ballard twins and a couple of Mexicans.
They up there right now?
Well, it was a group of four men rounding up Mr. Gulch's livestock, and none of them looked like any of Gulch's hands, so yes, sir, right now.
That sarcasm's most unbecoming, Eli. It's gonna hold you back in life, even worse than your lazy eye. All right, let's go. You ride with us again, Marson?
Will you help me?
I will try.
It'd be my pleasure. I don't work for the government.
Well, I got a telegram from some federal clowns in Blackwater that says otherwise. Stay with us, Marston. You never know. The Ballard twins might have set up an ambush. I'll be honest with you, Marston. I ain't for all this government interference.
Believe me, Marshal. Neither am I.
I try to keep the federal boys happy. I mean, we need all the help we can get. But what does a flannel-mouthed city boy who's never forked a bale of hay in his life know about a state like New Austin?
Nothing, I reckon.
All this manifest destiny hogwash, taming a wild land, bringing modernization and betterments to the West. It's only made the rich richer and the poor poorer, and it's killed a way of life.
Building a factory over a field ain't gonna help nobody I know.
Look at what they've done to the natives for God knows how many years now. It's hardly like they're gonna suddenly start respecting a man's right to work his land.
That's different. They're savages.
It ain't that different, Jonah.
We need to stick together, boy. Them rustlers might be waiting for us. Are you sure we're the Ballard twins, Eli? Not far now. Eyes open, boys. Come on. Everybody dismount.
Whoa, man.
Follow me.
Come on, easy up now.
Head for the fort. Be ready, boys. We're probably gonna be outnumbered.
And those bastards ain't short on firepower, neither.
Let's see how many there are. If we can take them alive, good. If not, smoke the sons of bitches.
Music to my ears, Marshal.
Look out! Rustler guards! Gun him down! My God! Help me out here!
You hear? I see one of them. There's one more for the vultures.
This is gonna be one hell of a massacre.
I spotted a lot of
them. Someone don't like me much.
Keep your eyes open. I saw a couple of snipers across the way. Look out! There are them snipers! Come on! Give them hell! Gunshots. Quick, let's go help my deputies. This looks as good a spot as any. Gather around and listen up. All right, stealthy as you can, boys. Let's get as close to those bastards as we can.
Get those bastards! Careful! Get down there! Watch out for me to go to the camp!
Good shooting, boy!
Thanks, Marshal. We're indebted to you with our lives.
Just get them cattle back safe.
All right.
Oh, thank you. Oh, thank you so much. Thank you.
Well done, Mr. Marston.
Yes, well done.
Now, about Williamson.
I'll do what I can. You know, as you can see, this country is infested with all manner of scum.
Say that again.
Well, one other thing, Marston. Mr. Johnson, sir. It's Mr. Wes Dickens. He's missing.
Who?
Mr. Wes Dickens, the tonics merchant. He was due in town last week.
Oh, the narcotic and bat piss salesman who cons housewives out of their money with promises of eternal youth.
Yes, him, but I think you're being a little unfair. He's helped a great many of the county, and many of the townsfolk are really missing him.
You hear that, Marston? We just butchered a gang of thieves, and the town is up in arms about a missing snake oil merchant. I am so glad to be serving such a wise and respectable people. Come on, Eli.
wedding's gonna be in town.
What's your problem?
Ah, Mr. Marston, how are you?
Good, Miss McFarlane. How are you?
I'm well. Would you mind riding with me to Armadillo? I've got to get some supplies and I could do with the company.
Of course.
You can take the reins. It wouldn't do for a terrifying bounty hunter such as yourself to be seen driven around by a woman. Hop on up, Mr. Marston. Can we stop wasting time and get on with it, please? Is there a problem, Mr. Marston? Can we get going? You're looking much better, considering you were almost buzzard food a couple days ago.
I have you to thank for that, miss.
So do tell me, have you needlessly risked your life since we last spoke?
No, miss, I have not.
Well, that's a relief. Perhaps there's hope for you yet.
I wouldn't bet on it.
Oh, there's always hope, Mr. Marston. You can't be a rancher in this kind of country if you don't believe that.
An admirable attitude, miss.
I suppose so. I can't think of any other way to stay sane, to be frank. What about you? Have you ever given up hope altogether?
Hope hasn't really entered into it. It's not really something I think about.
A peculiar outlook. I can't really say I understand you.
I can't always say I do either.
Oh, don't be so deliberately enigmatic.
I'm not, miss.
Yes, you are. You are being deliberately obscure as a substitute for having a personality.
I just know there are two theories to arguing with women, and neither one works.
I'm not even going to dignify that gibberish with a response. I think it's kind of funny I found you dying on the side of the road and now you're driving me into town.
You have a strange sense of humor.
Well, you must admit, it's an unusual start to a friendship.
I didn't realize we were friends, Miss McFarlane.
Oh, please. Now who's being funny? Listen, I know that business with Williamson is your business, but I don't know. You've been good to us, and I don't think you're a bad man. A little stupid, perhaps, but not rotten. I just worry about you gallivanting around these parts like you're some kind of deranged bounty hunter. Like Paul always says, don't go waking snakes.
I appreciate your concern for us lesser mortals, Mr. Farland. I really do. And if there was any other way out, I'd take it. I can assure you of that. Go.
You never did tell me where you live.
I have a small holding up in Great Plains.
A farmer? Yeah, and I'm the Queen of England. And at what point during your day of hunting down outlaws do you find time to raise chickens?
Only been at it 3 years or so. I guess I'm kind of new to it.
You're telling me? So who's looking after this farm of yours right now? So this is Armadillo. Manhattan it is not, but it does okay for us. The most important thing for you right now is getting yourself into Dr. Johnson's office to purchase some medicine. The first one's on me.
Thank you, miss. I'll pay you back.
I'm sure you shall. The doc's a good fellow. He saved your life, so be polite to him. Meet me in front of the general store when you're done.
Hello there.
Just finished helping him.
Hack. It could be. How are you, Fred?
You need something for that gout?
Thank you very much.
Here I am.
for driving me. It was nice to be able to enjoy the view for once, and a little company never hurts now and again.
You're more than welcome, miss. Least I can do. Thank you for the medicine.
Why don't you have a look around Armadillo? You can always take a stagecoach back to the ranch later.
I might just do that. Travel safely, miss.
Try not to get yourself shot. I won't be around to save you this time.
The rail keeps bringing more pilgrims out here. We'll be outnumbered.
Always a pleasure to see you.
Good to have some nice whaler.
I told him I wasn't buying any land until I found a proper career.
A headache just here.
Well, hello.
In this, my friend. Excuse me. Excuse me, sir. You need help? Mister, you alive?
Fuck. God damn it. Good heavens.
Excuse me?
I said, no, I'm not okay. Do I look like I'm okay?
You look pretty good for a corpse.
Praise be.
Move up, mister. Time to get you to a doctor or an undertaker. Whichever you need once we get to town.
St. Peter, open up them pearly gates. I'm coming home.
Oh. Come on, mister. Come on. Oh.
Hurry, sir. I'm bleeding like a badly butchered hog.
You'll be fine. Just focus.
You better take the reins. I don't think I'm strong enough.
I'm finished. Done for.
Just sit up straight, will you?
Head for Armadillo, friend.
Come on.
What is your name, friend?
John Marston.
Good God! Out of the frying pan into the fire!
Excuse me!
How many outlaws can a man encounter in one day?
You must have me mistaken with somebody else, friend.
The Bomber Twins, Walton's gang! I know who you are! My God! They come back and finish me off!
Looks like you got them all. Now, get me to a doctor.
What the hell happened to you?
Bandits, hoodlums, the scoundrels robbed me blind and left me to die.
I can see that.
Once again, a victim of my own success. They seem a man in a well-cut suit, and this happens.
Do you know who they were?
No idea. I'm not the kind of man who has enemies.
You do now.
I give so much, and still they take. We live in an uncivilized and graceless world, friend. Our maker has a funny sense of humor sometimes. Still, at least I met you, a good Samaritan in wolf's clothes. And forgive me, pain is playing rare havoc with my metaphors. They're still coming! You're killing me!
Get back on the
damn road! I knew you'd come.
What?
I knew this wasn't my time. He has a greater purpose for me.
You're delirious or playing dumb, friend.
Where's Amado? Faster, John! Faster!
Armadillo. We made it safe, you'll be happy to know.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. You're a gentleman and a true man of honor.
Coming from you, I doubt that means much, but I appreciate the civility.
I owe you, sir. And I always pay my debts. Jesus! But if I die, I'm sorry for it. If not, I'll be your man for...
Let's get you fixed up first. Then we'll decide what you're my man for. Who did?
He's missing. He's only a youngster. My boy is missing.
Where? Who took him?
Them people in the hills. Them hills near Hanging Rock. They took it.
Can't the police force help you?
No. They can't even help themselves. Please, sir. My son is missing. I need your help.
If I find him, I'll bring him back to you.
This town.
Lord above.
Nothing stupid now.
Let's go.
Mr. Marston, I've been hearing about your plans.
Have you, Miss McFarlane?
Yes, from Lee Johnson, to settle here and build a life for yourself.
I'm afraid those aren't my plans. See, I already have a life. Well, I had one, and I'm trying to reclaim it. Or maybe what you could say is that I had two, and I'm trying to end one of them so the other can survive.
You do so love to talk in riddles, Mr. Marston. Do you do that, I wonder, as a substitute for having anything interesting to say?
Probably, Miss McFarlane.
Oh, call me Bonnie, you fool. Call me Bonnie.
Miss McFarlane, I'm married. I have a son. I had a daughter, but she died. Years before that, I rode in a gang. We robbed banks, trains, held people ransom. We killed people we didn't like. Bill Williamson was in that gang. Now, if I don't capture my former brother in arms, great harm will befall my family. Now, I don't suppose any of this is very interesting to you, but I hope it explains why I wasn't so eager to talk about it.
No, I do understand. I had no idea. You poor man.
Even in this new country, memories don't really fade. My father was an illiterate Scot born on the boat into New York. He never saw his homeland, but to hear him talk about it, you'd imagine he only ever ate haggis and wore a kilt. And he hated the English for what they had done to his great-grandparents that he'd never met. People don't forget. Nothing gets forgiven.
That's true, especially when it comes to money. And you know, even now, after all his labors, my father's debts are still terrible. I worry every day about us losing the ranch. It would kill him.
My father died when I was 8 years old. His eyes were, well, let's just say he was blinded in a bar fight south of Chicago. My mother died during childbirth. She was a prostitute, and he was her, well, I don't know what he was. So I was sent off to an orphanage and ran away and fell in with a gang.
My word. What a difficult life you've lived.
The leader of the gang taught me how to read, taught me how to see all that was good in the world. He was a great man in a way.
But you killed people.
Sure. And I've suffered for it. And that's the life I left, or tried to leave. Said too much, Bonnie. I'm an uneducated killer, sent here to do all I can do well. Kill a man in cold blood so that another man may do his part to cut crime in an area, and a rich man can be elected governor on the back of these promises.
Civilization is a truly beautiful thing, Mr. Marston. Listen, can you help me?
Well, I can try. What do you need, money?
No, nothing so complicated. I need an extra hand to take out the herd to pasture.
Sure. Point me in the right direction.
Are you ready to learn how to herd some cows?
Well, how?
Thank you for telling me all that back there. It must have been hard for you.
Hope you understand now why I've been playing my cards somewhat close to my chest.
I didn't know you had a wife and child. Then again, I don't think I ever asked. They're lucky to have a man like you.
I ain't so sure about that, but thank you.
How are you, Miss McFarland?
Whoa there!
Whoa!
All right, let's see if you can herd cows as well as you can charm humanity.
He's just showing off now. Keep going, Mr. Mawson!
Now we need to move this entire herd out to the far pasture for grazing. Wave back and forth behind them. Keep them nice and tight. Might be your true calling, Mr. Marston. Either that, or you were a cow in a past life.
Thank you, Miss McFarland.
I'll see you later. I have work to do back at the ranch.
Let's go.
Ah, since you're here, you want to make yourself useful?
Not particularly.
Listen, son, I know you got a mission. Right now, I need another gun.
Why? What's happening?
We've had this problem for months with this group of bandits. We're getting drunk and murdering settlers. Last night, they went to a big place up near Ridgewood.
They burnt the place down, killed the men, burning most of them alive, and raped the women. Women folk then got their throats slit. One of them survived and walked in here this morning.
Anyway, we got a posse gathering up near Ridgewood. Will you ride with us?
All right.
Thank you, John Marston. It's gonna be a bloody job.
Huh. I don't think I know any other kind, sir.
Hey, wait up!
Let's hit the breeze, boys. Marston, I hear you caught up with Mr. West Dickens.
I did. For a man who claims to have found a remedy to all ailments, he was in pretty bad shape.
His tonic has helped a great many people. It's a medical breakthrough from the East, the result of years of research.
If only it could cure him of his diarrhea of the mouth.
I wouldn't be so dismissive of science if I was you. Times is changing fast.
He's no more a scientist than I am a priest. But people can spend their hard-earned money however they please.
He's certainly a character, that West Dickens.
I can't understand a goddamn word he's saying.
A more flannel-mouthed bunco artist I've never met.
Look, vultures.
I see them. Marston, you and Eli go check it out.
Man, this don't look too good.
Somebody was so busy killing people, they went and dropped their gun.
Your weak men. A pack of cowards is the most dangerous kind.
Some men are just born plain evil.
I think it's this land that makes them men, as much as the other way around. Men are born, and then they're formed. At least that's how I see it.
Who
done such a thing?
Any number of people, especially now the word's out we're cleaning up the county. Hunt Marshall or Vulture.
All right, let's go check it out.
Fire's still smoking. Those scumbags must still be around.
Come on! Let's pound leather, boys. Looks like they're headed for Ridgewood Farm.
Sons of bitches!
Didn't you once run a gang of outlaws, Marston?
Yeah, but not like that. It wasn't our way. At least it wasn't my way.
Killing and thieving's never right, boy. No matter how you dress it up.
Unless it's ordered by a court of law, you mean? You know as well as I do, Marshal. One way or another, some men gotta die.
This is too quiet. I got a bad feeling about this. Split up and search the area. John, you check the buildings in the barn.
Shed's clear, Marshal.
There's no good reason for that to be boarded up. Break that door down. Grab me and get your gun ready.
Holy sweet mother of mercy.
Please, please don't shoot me. Some bandits came by and took us hostage. They're holed up in the farmhouse. Some of my family is being kept hostage inside.
All right, boys. We need to get into that house right now.
So much cover! Shed in the back as soon as it looks clear.
Thank you.
Make a break for the shed when the coast is clear. There'll be a deputy waiting for you.
They did unspeakable things to me.
Look like that's all of them. Let's see how the hostages are doing.
Of that bunch gets $50.
It ain't about the money, Marshall. These are people's lives, people's homes.
Shut up, boy! We gotta get after those bandits! All right, let's find those bastards.
Come on!
Do you think they might be headed for Fort Mercer, Marshal?
What? Williamson's men?
Maybe. All this sure looks like their handiwork.
Makes sense if they took this road.
Come on, Marshal. This might be our chance.
What's your beef with Williamson anyway, Marshal?
Let's just say he's the currency in a complicated transaction.
What the hell are you talking about?
Some people I have the displeasure of knowing want him dead.
Why does that involve you?
We used to run in a gang together. It was once like family.
If this is how you treat your family, I'd hate to see what you do to your enemies.
That was a lifetime ago. And Baron...
Eyes up! You see that?
You just walk away now, John. I didn't kill you before, but I sure as shit will now!
Get yourself down here, Bill. You know you ain't man enough to stop me. You know I don't want to kill you, but I will.
You always did have a high opinion of yourself, John. Dutch always said you were an arrogant son of a bitch. I guess he was about right. Get him, boys! Everybody, take cover! In that shed!
You're still breathing. Come here, boy. Come on, Bessie. Give. Oh.
Norman Deke.
Fuck.
Nice to see you again, buddy. Thanks for your help, John. Norman here is going to help us get to Bill. Ain't you, Norman?
Thank you, Mr. Deke. Mighty kind.
Fuck you.
Hog time. Let's get him to jail.